Welcome to the session. In this session, I am going to talk about the production of solar grade silicon from quartz. Solar grade silicon or semiconductor grade silicon that can be produced from quartz by physical methods or by chemical methods also. Chemical methods, Siemens process. In this process, silica is reduced through a reaction with carbon in the form of coal, charcoal or metallurgical coke. And here the mixture, silica and coke or coal char mixture, that is heated up to 2000 degree centigrade, 1500 to 2000 degree centigrade in an electrode arc furnace. So by this reaction we will get silicon in liquid form. So the overall reaction is SiO2 plus C gives rise to Si plus CO2. Here silicon is obtained in liquid form at the bottom of the furnace. It is then collected by draining out and then it is cooled. The cooled silicon, liquid silicon, that forms metallurgical grade silicon. The silicon obtained by cooling liquid silicon, that is called metallurgical grade silicon. Its purity is 98% pure. This purity is not enough for manufacturing of semiconductor devices, as still higher pure silicon is needed for semiconductor devices. A number of methods are available for refining the metallurgical grade silicon or the increasing the purity of metallurgical grade silicon. A small amount of metallurgical grade silicon is further refined for the semiconductor industry. A small amount of metallurgical grade silicon, that is finely powdered. This powdered metallurgical grade silicon, that is made to react with anhydrous HCl at 300 degree centigrade in a fluidized bed reactor, and it forms trichlorosilane. So powdered silicon, when made to react with anhydrous HCl, it forms trichlorosilane, SiHCl3 and hydrogen. So here silicon forms its halide, that is SiHCl3, and along with silicon, the impurities which are present in the metallurgical grade silicon, impurities like iron, aluminum and boron, they also form their respective halides, FeCl3, AlCl3 and BCl3. Now the mixture contains trichlorosilane and also the impurities FeCl3, AlCl3 and BCl3. Among these trichlorosilane, SiHCl3, that has a low boiling point of 31.8 degree centigrade, and so the temperature of 31.8 degree centigrade is applied and the trichlorosilane is distilled out from the other impurities from the mixture. After removing the trichlorosilane, the leftover impurities concentration will be very very less, that will fall down to 1 ppba. Ppba stands for parts per billion atoms. So the impurities are separated from trichlorosilane. The trichlorosilane which is obtained, that is pure and that is made to react with hydrogen at 1100 degree centigrade for 200 to 300 hours, where we get the pure silicon. This is a trichlorosilane and this is hydrogen. At 1100 degree centigrade, we will get the silicon, pure silicon, and also hydrogen chloride, HCl. The silicon which is obtained here, that is very pure, and it is deposited onto thin polysilicon rods. In this way, we get highly pure polysilicon rods. This process is called as Siemens process. The silicon which is produced by Siemens process, that is called as polycrystalline silicon. These polycrystalline silicon rods, these are then broken to form the feedstock for the crystallization process. This is about the Siemens process of manufacturing solar grade silicon from quartz. Zone melting method, this is a purification method, not a method of synthesis. Zone melting method is the most widely used method in the industries. Here metallurgical grade silicon rods, they are heated to melt at one end. So in the first step, the metallurgical grade silicon rods, which are having purity 90%, they are heated to melt at one end. Say if we hold a rod, metallurgical grade silicon rod, vertically, top end is heated to melt. Then the heater is slowly moved down the length of the rod. Slowly the heater is moved down such that the part of the silicon rod which is exposed to the heater, that will be heated to melt. Remaining part of the silicon rod, that will be solidified. And here the heater is moved down the length of the rod, keeping small length of the rod molten as the silicon is cooled and resolidified behind it. So what actually happens here is, first the part of the metallurgical grade silicon rod is heated to melt, then it is again solidified. First heated, then cooled to solidify. So this happens from top to bottom. The basic point of melting and resolidification is, most of the impurities, they tend to remain in the molten region rather than resolidify. When the process was complete, most of the impurities in the rod, they have been moved to the end, where the part of the metallurgical rod is last melted. So impurities, if they are present in the metallurgical grade silicon, they tend to remain in the molten region, not in the resolidifying region. So they doesn't want to resolidify. This is the reason why, if we heat the metallurgical grade silicon rod from top to bottom slowly, then what happens, the impurities will remain in the molten region. At the end, when we come to the bottom of the rod, the impurities are all moved to the molten region, end of the rod. Now the small part of the end of the metallurgical rod, that will be cut and discarded. Now the remaining part of the metallurgical rod, after amputation, the remaining part of the metallurgical grade silicon rod, that is pure. And if we need still higher purity, then we'll repeat this process. This method is a purification method. This is called as a zone melting method. Production of solar grade silicon from quartz. Physical methods. Silicon is available in different forms, like single crystal silicon, polycrystalline silicon, amorphous silicon. Now I will talk about the production of single crystal silicon. Number of methods are available for the production of single crystal silicon, like Jouchralski process, float zone process, etc. Now we will discuss the Jouchralski process. Jouchralski process is the cheapest method and also the widely used technique for producing especially single crystal silicon. The single crystal silicon, which is produced by Jouchralski method, that contains impurities because the crucible which is used in this method dissolves, thus making the single crystal silicon impure. For electronic devices which are particularly used for high power applications, this single crystal silicon, that is not suitable, as its purity is low. In Jouchralski method, a crucible is taken and it is filled with the molten silicon. This is the crucible, you can see in the picture, and this crucible is filled with the molten silicon. This is molten silicon. This crucible is surrounded by heating coils and a seed crystal, single seed crystal, that is dipped into the molten silicon, and the seed crystal is slowly raised in the upward direction. As the seed crystal is slowly raised, the molten silicon solidifies in the pattern of the seed crystal. As the seed crystal is a single seed crystal, the molten silicon solidifies and it is formed as an ingot, silicon ingot. This silicon ingot is a single crystal silicon ingot. Silicon ingot is the silicon rod. It is then sliced into wafers, very thin wafers, for further processing into photovoltaic cells. In this way, single crystal silicon is produced by Joachimski method. Another method for manufacturing single crystal silicon is float zone process, denoted with FZ method. This method produces single crystal silicon having higher purity when compared to the Joachimski method, as in this method, crucible will not contaminate the single crystal silicon. In float zone process, a silicon rod that is set up on the top of a seed crystal and then lowered through an electromagnetic coil. So in this method, at the bottom we will have the crystal, seed crystal, I mean single crystal seed, and on the top of the seed crystal we will place the silicon rod, then we will move or we will lower the electromagnetic coil through the silicon rod. The electromagnetic coil's magnetic field that will induce an electrical field in the silicon rod. So the rod will be heated and it starts melting, especially at the interface between the rod and the seed. Now the electromagnetic coil, it will be moved in the upward direction, starting from the interface between the seed and the rod. So the area of the silicon rod which lies in the electromagnetic coil, that starts melting, and as we move the electromagnetic coil upwards, then it undergoes resolidification, and melting and resolidification occurs. During the resolidification, the silicon formed is the single crystal silicon, as the seed we are taking here is the single crystal seed silicon, and it is called as a silicon ingot. Whatever the method we are using, the single crystal silicon rods formed, they are then sliced with the help of a special sauce into thin wafers. The thin wafers are then doped to produce the necessary electrical field. After doping, they are coated to reduce the reflection, and then they are coated with electrical contacts to form the photovoltaic cells. Multicrystalline silicon casting process. Multicrystalline silicon devices, these are generally less efficient when compared to the devices made with single crystal silicon. Multicrystalline silicon devices, these are cheaper when compared to the single crystal silicon devices. Multicrystalline silicon can be produced in a number of ways. The most popularly used commercial method is the casting process. In this process, a mold is taken. You can see the mold in the picture. In this mold, the molten silicon is poured directly and it is allowed to solidify. It will lead to the formation of ingot, that is multicrystalline silicon ingot. Generally, the starting material for casting process is refined lower grade silicon. Then the final size of the crystals present in the ingot and also the impurities concentration present in the ingot, that is determined by many factors. One of the factors is the cooling rate. The mold is usually square shaped, and the ingot which is produced by casting process, that is cut or sliced into square shaped cells which fit compactly into a photovoltaic module. This is about the production of multicrystalline silicon by casting process. Next, amorphous silica. Amorphous solids are the compounds whose atoms are not arranged in a particular order. They don't have any crystal structure, but they contain a large number of defects. The defects may be structural defects or bonding defects. But these are advantages. Amorphous solids, they have some economic advantages. Because of these advantages, they are recommended for use in electric or photovoltaic systems. Solar powered consumer devices like wristwatches and solar calculators, they need generally low power. For these devices, amorphous silicon is commonly used. Amorphous silicon absorbs solar radiation 40 times more efficiently than the single crystal silicon. Single crystal silicon is expensive compared to multicrystalline silicon and also more expensive than amorphous silicon. But amorphous silicon, though cheaper, it absorbs 40 times more efficiently than the single crystal silicon. And a film made up of amorphous silicon of thickness 1 micrometer that can absorb 90% of the usable light energy which is incident on the film. This is one of the chief reasons that amorphous silicon reduces the cost of the photovoltaic devices. Other economic advantages of amorphous silicon are: amorphous silicon can be produced at low temperature and it can be deposited on low cost substrates like plastics, glass items, and also on the metals. Because of these economic advantages, amorphous silicon is the leading thin film photovoltaic material and it is extensively used for building integrated photovoltaic products.